Okay, so I want to talk to you about TM, which I have now been doing 41 years. 41 years. I don't remember exactly how I started. It was some kid I knew. I had just gone to college, and we were still kind of in the flush of the feeling of the 60s, and I just wanted to try any new thing that I heard about. And so I went and I learned TM, and I do remember the very first time I did it, and I remember that I was up the entire night because I never felt that good before, and I had terrible acne. I think I was about 18, and it all just went away, and I became a world famous comedian. That's my story. That's the entire story of my life.
This here represents the surface of life. Surface. And we see surfaces, surfaces. And about 300 years ago, scientists, they started wondering, what was this wood, and what was this metal, and what was it really? So they start looking into matter. So this side is matter, and this side is mind.
I'm a great supporter of transcendental meditation. I've been using it for almost 40 years now. And I think it is a great tool for anyone to have and to be able to utilize as a tool for stress.
I wanted to learn about transcendental meditation due to my dissatisfaction with some of the pleasures that I talked about. Drugs, the fame, the celebrity, the consumerism, the wealth, all of these things that pledge happiness but deliver so little of substance. And in learning about transcendental meditation, I found very quickly access to a deeper state of happiness, which is very profound. What it felt to me was like the dissolution of my idea of myself. I felt like separateness evaporated. I felt this tremendous sense of oneness. I find it, I'm quite an erratic thinker, quite an adrenalized person. And like, but what through meditation, I felt this sort of beautiful serenity and selfless connection. You know, my sort of tendency towards selfishness, I felt that kind of exposed as a superficial and pointless perspective to have. I felt a very relaxed sense of oneness. I felt like, I felt love, sort of love for myself, but also love for everybody else. A constant sense of absolute love between all of us. This, for me, is a beautiful thing.
And the scientists, they discovered molecules. Deeper they went, and they discovered these atoms. And like I say, they thought that was the smallest particle for a long time. All these things we learn about in school. They went deeper, and they find inside the atoms these little electrons and neutrons and protons. And they went deeper and deeper and deeper, smaller and smaller particles, smaller and smaller particles. They found four forces. On a deeper level, the four became three. And on a deeper level, the three became two. And then, about 30 years ago, modern science, quantum physics, discovered the unified field. The unity of all the particles and all the forces of matter.
3 o'clock in the afternoon, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, that nervous system shot.
Right.
We're all the same.
How do you do
20
it?
Minutes.
What do you do? Talk me through it.
You take your nervous system, and it's the result of it is you come out and you've rebooted the system, and you can now have a good part of the second part of your day.
It is possible for every man to go deep within and saturate his conscious mind with inner happiness, with that unlimited intelligence that dwells at the source of thought.
Not only did they discover the unified field, but they found that everything that is a thing emerges from this field of no thing. Unmanifest it is. Unmanifest. It is no hyphen thing, but all things come from it. Anything that is a thing has emerged from this field of unity. It's oneness.
I want to start right off with a very simple working definition of transcendental meditation. Number one, TM is a very simple technique. It's simple, not because it's simplistic or a beginner's meditation, but because there's an elegant simplicity to the practice. Very profound, elegant simplicity to the practice. Number two, it's natural. There's no manipulation, there's no suggestion. Every human being can practice transcendental meditation as well as every other human being. Very simple to learn and very enjoyable to practice.
Actual practice involves thinking of a word devoid of meaning. We don't know the meaning. We don't try to know the meaning. And the principle is that if we know the meaning, then meaning is a static thing.
The scientists know this exists, but if they wanted to get there, you can't get there. It's unmanifest. You can't walk into this field. But any one of those scientists could practice a technique, transcendental meditation, which, remember, true happiness is not out there. You're given a mantra, a very specific sound, vibration, thought. Very specific. It needs to be life-supporting at all deeper levels. And that mantra that you're given, that Maharishi gives, the key that opens the door. The mantra turns the mind within. Turns the awareness within. And you naturally dive.
I like to use the metaphor or the analogy of an ocean. You're on a small boat, you're in the middle of the ocean, out in the middle of the ocean, and all of a sudden you get these huge swells, these huge 40, 60 foot high waves, and you could think, oh my God, the whole ocean is an upheaval. Well, not really, because if you do a cross section of the ocean, you see these little 40 foot high waves, and the ocean is like, in reality, a mile deep, and the ocean is active on the surface, but at the depth of the ocean, it is naturally silent. And it doesn't matter if those waves are 200 foot high waves, at the depth of the ocean, untouched, it is naturally silent. And the analogy is our mind. The surface of our mind is the active thinking mind. All the things that we're thinking about all during the day, it's like the waves on the surface of the ocean. And there's a natural inclination, a natural desire to have some inner calm, some inner clarity, some inner focus, some inner inspiration, some inner peace, some inner happiness.
Why is it natural? Because each deeper level of mind and each deeper level of intellect has more happiness. And the deeper levels of mind and deeper levels of intellect correspond to deeper levels of matter. At the borderline of intellect, we transcend. Transcend is the key word. It means to go beyond. You're going beyond field of relativity, duality, experiencing oneness. Pure, unbounded, infinite consciousness.
Being is bliss in its nature, it's infinite happiness. Mind is always moving in the direction of greater happiness. It is the experience of everyone. Wherever the mind goes, it goes in the direction of greater happiness. And because the nature of inner being is bliss, infinite happiness. Therefore, the mind during transcendental meditation takes that inward course in a most spontaneous manner.
This consciousness has qualities, infinite creativity, intelligence, energy, love, power, and bliss, dynamic peace, always been there, never had a beginning, it is and it will be forever. Unbounded, infinite, eternal, immutable, immortal consciousness, fullness. Any human being can experience this easily and effortlessly with transcendental meditation. Transcendental meditation is just a vehicle to get you here. When you experience this level, you enliven it, and it grows in the individual. So if you started with a ball of consciousness this big, everyone has consciousness. Consciousness is the way to understand consciousness. If you took it away, you'd see what it really is. If there wasn't any consciousness, we wouldn't exist. And if we did exist, we wouldn't know it. It's the I am-ness of life. It is life itself.
We take a specific thought which suits us, which is called the mantra, or a suitable sound for us, which we receive from the trained teacher of transcendental meditation. And these teachers are found everywhere in the world. I have trained them properly, and they give a suitable word. And the man experiences the thought of that sound and starts minimizing that thought to experience the finer state of that thought, until the source of thought is fathomed and the conscious mind reaches the transcendental area of being. So from gross thought to the subtle state of thought, to the subtler, to the subtlest state of thought, this is the path of transcendental meditation, till the mind, conscious mind, reaches the bliss consciousness or transcendental consciousness, or pure consciousness, or the state of being.